Hi, I'm Kara Lee, and I want to give you an example of a more complicated truth table problem. Okay, so I made up this question. It says, if B or C, then not A and B. So there's a lot of different components here. We also, in my open math, have symbols. So I replace the if then with an arrow, and the not with the tilde. So you might see it that way also in the online homework system. Okay, so I don't want to try to do all this in my head. Like, okay, B or C is true, not A is false. There's no way I can keep all that in my head. You might be able to do that on some of them. If you can, more power to you. But I want to show you a step-by-step way to make the intermediate columns you need to get to that ending statement. Okay? So we're going to break this down into pieces. So B or C, that's one operation, right? That's an or. So I'm going to underline that. Then we also have not A. So that's another column that I can make because we have the A column, but we don't have the not A column. Then we have an and. So we have not A and B. And also sometimes we put it in parentheses to be really clear that that's one whole quantity. And then we have our last statement, which is if this, then that. So that will be the very last column. Okay? So I'm going to make first a B or C column. Then I'm going to do not A. Then I'm going to do not A and B. Okay, I think I have everything. This one, that one, and then the last column is going to be our final statement. These a little longer. Okay, so the last one will be, I'll just use the shorter version here. B or C, if B or C, then not A and B. Okay, so let's go through these columns one at a time. The beauty of this is now I only have to look at two columns at a time, or maybe even just one column. So B or C, I'm only going to look at B, the columns B and C, and then I'm going to think of what does or mean? Or means one or the other or both. Okay, we use the inclusive or in most math cases. So B or C, one or the other has to be true. One or the other. One or the other. Okay, those are both false. So the or is false. One or the other. One or the other, and both false. So you've got a nice little pattern there. Okay, that's the or. Then we have not A. So not A is the opposite of A. So if A is true, not A is false. So I'm going to do the complete opposite of the A column. True, 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 true. Okay. Now I need not A and B. And by the way, if you want to try the rest of this, feel free to pause it and then check your answer. So now I'm going to look at the not A and the B column. I'm only going to look at those two columns. And I'm going to think, what does and do? And means they both have to be true. You have to be wearing jeans and the hat. So both have to be true. So I'm gonna try to get my fingers here. Use your fingers. They're not both true, so that's false. They're not both true. They're not both true. They're not both true. They're both true. That's the only time the and will be true. We have another true. False and false. Okay, does it help to break it down like this? Helps me. Now we have B or C. If B or C, then not A and B. So I'm only going to look at these two columns and I'm going to do the if then rule, or think of it as the if then operation. If then means if something like elections are a good example. If I get elected, I will meet my campaign promise. So if I get elected but I don't meet my campaign promise, that is false. So the only time an if-then is false is if you get elected but you don't meet your promise. Again, we get elected but don't meet our promise. Again, if you don't get elected, if the if part isn't true, we can't say anything about this because you didn't say anything about if you didn't get elected. So we say that those are true. If the if part is false, then it's true no matter what. If you get elected and you do meet your campaign promise, that's great. That's true. That's true. I got elected, but I did not meet my campaign promise, so that's false. I did not get elected, so it doesn't matter. I'm not expected to meet my campaign promise if I didn't get elected. Okay, so I hope that helps break down one of these more complicated examples for you. If you see just this in My Open Math, write out the whole table and write out all the intermediate steps. That way you can focus on one single operation at a time. Okay, let me know if you have any questions.